I'm James Price, the writer of Street Hassle. Street Hassle was actually a part of a feature-length script I've written called Saturn's Day, which follows a series of characters over the course of one Saturday night in Glasgow. It's quite a dark film. I'd say Street Hassle, although being really dark and gritty itself, is probably the lightest of the stories, the kind of the easiest to sit through. It's quite a, I don't know if I'd use the word fun, but enjoyable read. My main goal with Street Hassle was to write something that was really entertaining and authentic at the same time. Sometimes I get a bit bogged down with making things too realistic and too authentic that takes away from entertaining factor. So I was trying to walk a line and find something that was a happy medium and included both. And I think I managed it quite well with Street Hassle. I'm quite proud of the script. Yeah, I took a lot of inspiration from the Wire characters of Johnny Weeks and Bubs, the Welsh film Adam and Paul. The initial spark also came from the Lurid song Street Hassle, which is, I think, is a brilliant song. And although it's set in New York, there's a Glaswegian sensibility to it. It's really dark but optimistic sounding at the same time. It's a really, really good song. But another film that really inspired us, the Nick Gomez film, Laws of Gravity. I think there's just something really absorbing about the way that film was made. It's like a semi-documentary. It's really strong, and I think if I was to make Street Hassle, I would be aiming to capture that style, that run and gun, raw, real, authentic street Y style, which I think Nick Gomez did perfectly. You could find allegories in the idea of killing somebody over fake money. My main goal with the script was just to entertain the viewer, entertain the reader. We rarely get an unbiased look into this world, this kind of corner of Glasgow. So I would like to be the person that can invite people into the tent, let them have a safe look around. I found out about short scripts online, and I submitted it from this internet cafe here. I'm like 90% sure I found out about short scripts on Facebook. And I remember being amazed at the judges. I'm still overwhelmed at the idea that Jeremy Irons, Tony Grissoni, Flida Lloyd, and the 18 other amazing judges actually, even if they skimmed through Street Hassle or just looked at the title page, that's enough for me. It's unbelievable. I still even saying it out loud, it doesn't feel real. I remember finding out I made the quarterfinals, and I thought, oh, that's really cool. I thought maybe it was like a sympathy vote, maybe there wasn't enough people from Scotland submitting scripts, and I just made the cut-off. But then I made the semi-finals, which was unbelievable as well. I never expected it. I was, even if I didn't make the top three short film scripts, I was ready for bragging about making the semi-finals. When I submitted, I never realised how good the prizes were. I thought the prize was that Jeremy Irons and Tony Grissoni and the rest of the amazing judges read your script. I thought that was the prize, but got £500. I bought myself a new telly, a PS4. Not had a telly since February, so I feel like I'm back in the land of the living. With my new telly, I'm going to get tuned into Fargo, the second series of True Detective, which I loved. I think I'm the only person who liked it. Thought it was amazing. I remember having just enough money to submit short scripts. I had a short film that I directed that I wanted to submit to the London Short Film Festival, which I submitted, but it wasn't successful. But another short film that was written by me got in, so it's not all bad. Noisy. I never went to college or university to study script writing or filmmaking. I taught myself how to write scripts from just watching films and reading the scripts of the films that I loved. So having people like the amazing judges read something I scribbled while sitting in my wee room in Springburn in Glasgow, it's unbelievable. It's beyond words, really. There's nothing I can say in this video that will sum up what a buzz or how good a feeling it is to have something that I've written recognised by such established and talented people who I've grew up watching and loved their work. To sum this video up, I would just like to say a big massive thank you to ShoreScripts. I would give you two thumbs up, but I'd drop my phone. Just thanks, man, it's beyond words. I really appreciate it.